Hello, my most amazing artists. Today we're going to be needing a piece of paper, a pencil, a Sharpie, or a black marker if you can't use a Sharpie or a permanent marker, and then something to color with. That could be crayons, markers, colored pencils, whatever you have at home. I'm going to be turning my name into bubble letters. We're talking all about how to make bubble letters today. Now, this paper shows how to make the word art in bubble letters. You start by writing the name very lightly in pencil. So you write that word very light and spread across your paper really big. Then you hug the letters with a bubble, then you erase the insides, add a little highlight for that shiny bubble, and then a shadow to make it look 3D. So let's go through those steps. I'm going to lightly write my name. I'm pressing really light with my pencil because I know that I'm going to be erasing these lines that I'm drawing anyway. So drawing light, light, light. Now if you have a big name, make sure that you are making your letters a little smaller to make them fit on the page. Then I'm going to hug my letters with a curve. Now I'm not just drawing a circle around my letters. I'm making sure to curve my bubble, almost going and touching it, but not quite, giving it a really close hug with that bubble, like the bubble is squeezing over top of the letter. Don't forget the insides of your letters too, and if you have any dots like I do. Now, instead of erasing that middle letter that we first drew, go ahead and outline just the bubble that we just outlined. So I'm going to outline only the bubbles that I just drew around my letter. So I hugged each one of my letters and I'm going to go and hug them again by tracing over top with a Sharpie or a black marker. Remember, if you're working with a Sharpie, a permanent marker at home, make sure that you have a piece of paper under your paper. That way it doesn't get messy on the desk or table you're working on. Then I'm going to erase all of my pencil lines to really clean it up. I even used a big eraser to help me move quicker. So after I trace and then erase, now I'm going to create the highlights on my bubbles. That would be the shiny part of a bubble that makes it look 3D. So it's leaving this little spot of white. I'm going to make sure that these are the areas that I'm not going to color when it comes time for that later. Now I'm going to add a shadow. If I hold my arm up to the paper, you'll see that the shadow is only on one side of my arm. That's because the light is on top of it and making a shadow beneath it or on one side. So I'm picking one side of my letters. In this case, it's the left side. And I'm going to make a shadow on the left side of all sides of the letter. So I'm just doing that by adding an extra little line and coloring it in. That's going to make it really look 3D. Now I'm going to give all of my name a hug, going all around it. Now this is like circling it, but hugging it close, but this time the whole time. The whole name, and I'm gonna do it one more time. So going and following your curvy line one more time. Close, but never touching. Just like we give air hugs now. Now I'm going to color in those last lines. So the space between the two lines is for you to color in with that marker. That might take a little while. Remember, my video is fast forwarded. Now, if you've done that, it's time to color. You can color your letters however you want. I would suggest leaving the highlight white so that way it looks more like a shiny bubble and 3D. I'm only going to color the bubble part of my letter. I'm going to leave the rest black and white. I'm doing this kind of tie-dye technique by doing this up and down zigzag with each color of the rainbow in rainbow order. But you could use any colors and any method to decorate that you want. You could do polka dots inside, stripes, whatever. You're the artist. All right, artists, have fun. I can't wait to see you design your names.